In the past, rigging a character was something that only a selective few could do. Although, this can be true for creating advanced rigs for films and games. But the general everyday rigs can now be made easily without any intermediate or advanced knowledge of the rigging. It becomes possible through automatic rigging like AutoRig Pro. In this video, we're going to learn how to rig a character with AutoRig Pro in minutes without learning how to create and optimize skeletons. There are a few warnings that I should mention before starting the process because doing these things can ruin your rig. These are common mistakes that you ask in the comments, so I thought you should know these before we start. First of all, do not delete any object or bone that AutoRig Pro has generated. Do not rename any bone, and do not edit collections or hierarchies. When you're selecting the joints to move and put it in position, make sure you box select them, not individually selecting them. Okay, with that aside, let's start. When you import your character into the scene, make sure that it's in the center of the world and it faces front camera. To check that, just press number 1 on the keypad to switch to the front camera, and your character's face should be toward the camera. Your character should be in T pose or A pose. And if you did any adjustment like scaling or moving it into place in order to put it in the center of the camera or rotate it to face to the front camera, make sure to apply the transforms by pressing Ctrl plus A and selecting all transforms. Okay, first make sure that your fingers are spread and straight and the palm of the hand is facing down to the ground. This character is just one mesh, but for the best result, make sure to separate the eyeballs, the teeth, and the tongue. Okay, let's separate them right now. Now we have the character itself, the eyes, lower teeth, upper teeth, and tongue. Now let's start. In this video, we're going to create a general and simple rig for the character. And in the later videos, we're going to deep dive into the features of the AutoRig Pro to see what we can actually do with AutoRig Pro. Okay, let's start. Open the N panel or the side panel by pressing the N. Go to the ARP. We can do the classic manual rigging, but nowadays AutoRig Pro comes with a smart feature. Just click on the character, get select object, full body. You can use facial only, but right now we're going to do the full body. Click OK. It jumps into the front camera. Here you can turn your character to adjust the rigging. You can click on the guess markers to see if it can find the placement of the bones or not. Let's check it. Nice. It's pretty accurate actually. Look at them. It's pretty accurate. We can adjust things by clicking them and pressing G to move. But for the sake of this video, I'm going to delete this and do the smart rigging without guessing the markers. Let's delete them. Imagine the guess markers didn't work. Let's just do it by hand. Click add neck. You see in the right where you should place the neck. It's around here. Add chin. Of course, it should be your chin. Add shoulders. I place them here. Maybe a little bit more down like this. Add wrist, add hand tip, spine root, ankles. You can change the type of the skeleton depending on your export. You can use the ARP default, you can use UE4 mannequin or UE5 mannequin. I'm using UE5 mannequin because I want to export it to the Unreal Engine. Click add thigh, add knee, and add elbow. Okay, let's see our character. It needs a little bit of adjusting. This is the process if your guess markers didn't work, but I'm just going to click on the guess markers again and continue from there. The number of the fingers are 5. If your character have different number of the fingers, you can change this number. For now, we keep these settings on the default. Click on the guess fingers. And as you can see, it finds the joints of the fingers. Isn't that nice? Just with a few clicks, we didn't do anything. We select our character and click guess markers, guess fingers. We clicked 2 buttons and we are here. Next is the spine count. We're not going to change these settings for now. We're going to deep dive in these settings later. Right now, we want to keep it as simple as possible. For the spine, we select arch UE and clavicle tilted UE. Now click to add facial. In the add facial, as you can see, we have a few markers that we should set. But first of all, it actually finds the eyes geometry. The eyeball is one object. We can separate it to left and right and select two. We can remove some markers, for example, the eyebrows if you don't need. We can select the tongue object, just search it here, and teeth object. If you separated the teeth to the lower and upper like me, select two. If not, select one. I'm select two, upper teeth and lower teeth. Then we should place the markers. Make sure that your symmetry is turning on if your character is a symmetrical character. Now let's just place these first. These are for the cheeks. Just place them like here. This should be the ears. This one should be top of the ear. Let me see. This one should be the bottom of the ear. Something like this should be fine. Bring these to the front too. This is the nose. Bring it here, and it's in the nose bridge. Here and here. Okay. This is the lips. And this is the chin. Let's just bring forward the chin. Okay, now the lips, and adjust them in place. It's pretty fine. Let's bring the lips a little bit upper around here. And here a little bit down. Okay. The eyes. Bring them forward. Shape them in place. Make sure that your markers stays on the eyelids, not inside the eye. Nice. Now the eyebrows. Okay, nice. Let's check it once more. It seems everything is fine. Let's adjust the chin. Fine tune a little bit and just click on the OK. Make sure to check the override existing rig. That if your character, if your mesh, if your model comes with an armature modifier, even if it doesn't have a rig and it's just a modifier, it will ruin your work. So make sure to check this one and click on the go. Okay, our skeleton is generated right now. Okay, the next thing, go to the AutoRig Pro and to create the bone for the ponytail, click on the add limb and chain spline IK. We have a new chain down here. Just put them in place. We don't need to do anything else for now. We can add a lot of things, but for now, just click match to rig. A rig generated for our character, but as you can see, it's not doing anything for now because it's not binded to the character. So we need to fix that. Go to the skin. In the engine, you can use heatmaps or voxelized. There is a voxel heat diffuse skinning engine that is an add-on. You should buy the add-on in order for it to work with the AutoRig Pro. But the default options in the AutoRig Pro are heatmaps and voxelized. You can experience with each one. There are things that each one of them do better. But for now, we use the voxelized. We don't want to change anything. Type 1, voxel resolution 7. Press Ctrl Tab to come out of the impose mode. Select your character, select your rig, and click on bind. My character already had a rig, so I removed the modifiers, but I forgot to remove the vertex groups. And the error for me saying that there are already vertex groups. Do I want to remove them? I do. But probably you don't see this error if your character didn't have a rig before you start binding it. Click on OK. Okay, the binding is done. I ended up unselecting selected bones only and selecting vertices only. Unchecked scale fix and check preserve volume in order to rig my character. This is the hand IK. The foot. Okay. Everything seems fine. Because we had the hair and we didn't separate the hair model, the placement of these bones is not correct. So select the bone, go to the rig, edit reference bone, and edit these bones here. Click match to rig, go to the mask, update armature, and OK. OK, it's working right now. Let's check the eyes. Oh, we forgot to select everything. We need to select everything and then bind. We didn't bind the eyes, lower this, eye this, and tongue. Okay. Again, go to the pose mode. It's just fine. The eyes seems okay. We need to adjust the center of the eye later. The eye, we bring the center back here to see what's gonna happen. Match to rig. Go to update armature. Okay. Okay. It's much better right now. You need to play with the adjustments, but you can always go to the rig, edit reference bone to change the reference bone. Okay, let's see the jaw. The mouth didn't rig pretty well. As you can see, the jaw also pulls down the upper lip. Okay, this needs weight painting to fix. Leave that aside, the shoulders and the thigh. These bones need a little bit fixing too. But for the first try, this is a great trick to have for just a few clicks. In the later videos, we're going to adjust them by weight painting and explore more features of AutoRig Pro. As you can see, we need weight painting for these kind of areas. You can also buy the add-on for voxel heat diffuse skinning and try that in order to see what the result should be. That's it for this video. If you're going to continue, the video become much more longer and it become boring. So I create more videos about AutoRig Pro. Until then, make sure to hit the like and subscribe to the channel. Have a great day. Bye bye.